Hello everyone, welcome. This is a tutorial in Blender 0.75 and we are going to make a table. So we are going to make a table. This you must know that this tutorial is for beginners. So I have deleted all the elements in my scene and I will create a curve which is a boss. This boss I will be in the front view and rotate about y 90 degrees like that. Hit tab for edit mode and now we have this vertices and we have this vertices and we have this. So I will make something. So I'm in the edit view and I will try to make something. It may be like a table. So I will try to emulate this curve. Take these vertices and scale on X 0. We can change the font to be something like that. Alright, so this one will be in the top and this one will be in the right. Move this one like that. So you can imagine any shape that you want. And if you have search online, you will find a lot of shapes for the leg of the table. And exactly the modern ones has something which is maybe fantasy or maybe fantastic. So I will save this file first. And let's continue what we have make. So we have now a curve. We can use this curve at the moment and save. So go to the curve panel and make sure that the type is 3D and with it it's full. You can use 12 and the resolution. I will use big resolution like 4. Depths, let's try 0.1. 0.1 is very large. 0.05 and 0.05 is 0.05 is alright. So we can increase the depth and increase the resolution. We have now around 80 vertices and with the resolution increase the vertices increase. My model will be simple, so I am not care about the vertices count and I will stick with these ones. Let's apply the scale and now I will shift D on X and move this one onto this layer. Maybe I will use it later and let's convert it to mesh. Go to edit mode, select this one and shift S cursor to selected and control shift alt C geometry to 3D cursor, origin to 3D cursor. Why I have done that? Because I will apply now the mirror modifier around this one and it's happened. So what we have now is the legs. Alright, so if you see in your I may see in your in your legs of table, you the this one will be increased. You can do it with many methods. You can choose that and extrude scale shift Z 1.3 and take these ones like that, and you will get this shape, and you can apply subdivision surface of level 2 and smooth modifier. It's very high poly legs. Alright, so we have now make the legs. Let's make the which is the upper part. It's very simple. Create a plane. This plane, let's see, it will be this plane. We are now in metric dimensions. This plane will be in the y 3 meters and on the x 2.4. like that. So we have now this plane, extrude on Z like that, and I will take the faces, these faces, and shift D and separate by selection. We can isolate these ones, and so what I am going to make a loop here, a loop here, and another loop here, and another loop here, and take these faces, these ones, click here and select these faces and extrude scale shift Z 1.0. maybe something like that. And also this one's extrude scale shift Z 1.0. Alright, so now we have make the this part. So these edges, the upper edges, extrude scale shift Z, and these ones also extrude scale shift Z. So after that we can apply, as I have mentioned, I will try to make a high poly table. This table isn't suitable for game design or for animations, as I am looking for high poly table. So I will make the subdivision surface and smooth modifier, and let's make the shape. Take these edges here, minus 0.99, and these edges here 0.99, and these edges here minus 0.99, also these edges here 0.99, and these edges here 0.99, also the remaining one 0.99, and these ones 0.99. So there is something wrong here. We have forget to make minus 0.99, and so now we have make this part, and we can modify the shape a little bit by taking these ones and some loops cut here and loop cut here. If you find these rims is big, you can scale it, but we need one loop here and another loop here. So re-isolate, and we now have finished the table, but we want to add some screws to make this table looks like much more realistic. And this one will be, let's go here, shift C, and add some. So we will add cylinder of 12 vertices and take these ones X only faces, extrude scale shift Z, extrude Z like that. So now we have a screw, we can extrude scale shift Z, extrude scale shift Z, and extrude scale shift Z, Alt M at center. Apply the mirror modifier, smooth, and we have now make simple screw. We can move it to layer 1 and scale it to match the table, and scale 0.1 and scale another time, rotate around Y, so now we have this screw, and it's really a good time to make an array, but first we need to scale it, shift X like that. So we can make an array on first. We'll apply the rotation and the scale and make an array on Y axis, move that like that, and let's say we have 12 1, and increase these ones. So we can mirror them here, make this object as mirror, or select the shift S cursor selected and shift A, add an empty. Where is the empty? An empty plane axis, and select the screws and mirror them, add mirror modifier around empty, and here we are, so we have made and save some time with copying the same screws in the other time. So what we need to make is to shift Z and rotate around Z 90 degrees, rotate 90 degrees, let's rotate 90 degrees like that and so it's a very simple process and it will make the final image to be looks like much better. And the same process by mirror modifier around the empty, but this time will be on Y like that. So we have make the table and we can take this one here and shift the Y like that. We have modeled around 70% of the table. There are some things. What is the remaining part? If you looking in the right also, so we need to make a stand between this one and this one. We can make it by using a new cylinder, or we can firstly I want to join them, these ones to join them. So I have found two ways to make the stand, and the first or the best one, let's try to make an empty cylinder first. And it will be vertices. Let's make it 8 and scale. Scale again, rotate around X 90 degrees. So we'll scale shift Y, scale shift Y, and like that. And scale on Y. We can apply subdivision surface and smooth modifier, go to edit mode, make loop cuts, and let's see, and it seems nice. So we will apply the mirror modifier to save time around empty object, and it happens. So the final part is to take these ones, not the empty. I will move the empty to this layer, and we have the screws, we have all the part. So we will take this one, or we can now texture and duplicate it in the final part. So let's apply the, let's try to make a metal. I will using of course cycles, and let's make shiny black metal. Apply mix shader, and we have also glossy shader. This one will be black. And this one will be 0.7, this one will be 0.08, and this one also will be shiny black, and this one will be shiny black. The screws will be chrome, and this chrome will be simple glossy with mix shader, and this will be 0.8, and this will be 0.07, and this will be completely pure white, and this also will be pure white, and also big man, and all the screws will have the same chrome. And also this one will be chrome. We have to scale shift Z like that, and or we can make solidify modifier, solidify, and where is that? So if I will be here, so solidify doesn't work, it must. So we will try to recalculate turmeric first, and it seems recalculate normals inside. So what is the problem with these ones? And it seems that the problem, we must scale shift Z slightly like that, and scale again like that, so we have this chrome. We can now move the screws. G, Y, so the remaining part is make this one to be wood. So in top view, select all and UV project from view, go to your UV image editor and apply the wood material. We can now scale. Hello everyone and welcome. Let's continue what we have left in this table. So the remaining part is to make a floor. I will select all, and with also the empty object, and move this like here, and shift C. Let's add a plane, scale 20, and this plane, we must add a floor plane, but now we will make it white or something like that. And now let's add here an area light lamp area, and this area will be here, and the size will be 1 meter, and light will be like that. We can increase the size like this and go to front view, add here another lamp area, rotate 2 meters, this will be like that, and 44, and this one will be slightly yellow like a sun. And add a camera, go here control alt 0, look camera to view, so this is the table. You can hit shift Z to find or to make a view of your table. So it seems the light is far, and we haven't added the final part. Go to this side and select all these ones, shift DZ, rotate around Z 90 degrees and scale like that. You can now, so you can now scale again and scale on Y. This one will be put here in this side like that. So we have the table, but the light is isn't as I have expected, so I will try to change. Let's make here a lamp point with 0.9 and like this, and so here the table has become more realistic. So let's render this table, take any view you want, like this one, and go to your render setting, will be 100, and the samples will be, let's say, 1000, and clump direct 1, as I have using CPU, so X will be 16 and Y will be 16, and let's render this now, and I will finish it and post it to the my Behance profile. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you find this tutorial is useful for you, you can subscribe for my channel on YouTube and leave a comment in this video. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next one.